going to be my entry into the Say Cheese group build, hosted by Felis Barcelonensis and 1/35th scale non-prolific scale model builder, a.k.a. Jens. I had to really pour through some photos to try and decide on what one I wanted to pick, because there's so many. And they had to fit what I had, or what I could use in my stash. I mean, there's only so much you can do. I didn't want to go and spend $1,000 on kits and figures and stuff like that to try and emulate what I see in photographs. I mean, when it comes to building with photographs, it can either be really expensive or it can be really, really simple. It depends on the composition. And of course, I tend to go grand. I don't like simple, apparently. And the photograph that I settled on is this one. And it is a bit grand. Because that's just how I like things, apparently. Now, what I plan to build is going to be a bit of a conversion on some of the kits I'm going to use. I have two half tracks that I have in my stash. One is the kit that you see in front of you here. It's the D, which appears in the convoy that's in the photograph. I don't know if there's any of the Pioneer ones in the photograph or not, but I mean, it's a simple modification to change it into something other than a Pioneer. It's no big deal. But the other kit that I have is a B, and in the photo I'm not 100% sure that I can see if there's any B's in there, and I'm not even sure if the B's were still in service at the time. Now, half tracks were really prolific. They were all over the place. They were really useful vehicles. They were made a lot of them, and they were in every theater of the war. And they tended to last in varying periods of time. So, you know, it's a crapshoot as to whether or not the vehicle may have been still in service or not. There may have been a couple of them still around. I don't know. I'm going to look closer at the photo. I don't think there's any B's in there, but, you know, you can't see the front of every vehicle, and that's one of the most identifying features of the B, is the bow, or the front of the vehicle. It's very different than the D. So, we'll see what happens. I may end up using it and just say, that's what I'm going to use. I do have a D that's already built and waiting to be put on a diorama. It's on my shelf. The only thing it would need to be incorporated into this scene would be a winter camouflage. Now, it was built some time ago, so some modifications would have to be made to it. And it was a while ago that I built it, and there's some problems with it, so I'd have to mess with the kit in order to get it to work. It's also missing a driver. It doesn't have a driver, which would probably bother me if I tried to include it in the scene, because it looks like it would need one. So I don't know what I'm going to do quite yet on there, but I am going to definitely use this kit that you see in front of you and some of the figures that you see in that bundle that's there, the Stalingrad figures. Some of those are good, some of those are absolutely awful. And the reason why I want to use two half tracks is I want to have the photographer that's taking the photograph, and that's the scene is based on, standing in the back of one of the half tracks taking the photograph. That's what I want. But I don't know how I'm going to do that yet. I mean, the figures that I was going to use, these guys here, they came from one of the Dragon Super kits for Tigers there from ages ago. It comes with a trio of photographers. I think it's three. It's two, definitely. Of photographers that are taking pictures of one of the first initial Tigers before it went into combat. And I don't remember the name of the kit number. But either way, so those are the figures that I'm going to use. But they're not in winter camouflage or winter uniform, so I'd have to modify them. But the state of attrition during the war is not every soldier was wearing winter camouflage during various parts of the war. They just were ill-equipped photographers are rare echelon fellows, so they might have been wearing proper gear. I'm not sure. So, but I'll think about it and puzzle with it and stuff like that. But this is my plan. This is where I'm going to go. I'm going to start on it. I don't know if I'm going to get a start on it today. I've got a bunch of things that I want to start today already. But we'll see what happens, I guess. But this is my project, I guess, for the next little while. This one. And there's another group build that I'm also starting at the same time. That is going to be pretty much a handful as well. We'll have to see. But that's in another video. I think that's it for now. Yeah. So I want to say thanks to Felis and Jens for hosting the GB. It's definitely going to be an interesting one. I'm hoping to see some really cool and interesting builds come out of this. And because it's such an interesting topic, you could really go crazy taking all kinds of liberties in what you do. The photojournalists made most of the reference material that we use in what we do now, so it's kind of a tip of the hat to them in a way. So anyway, I think that's all I got. You guys be good. Enjoy your group build. Keep your stick on the ice. Bye for now.